So today we will learn top 3 card forces and then move on to some recommendations. In each of the video, we will be forcing the 3 of clubs. So let's start. So as I riffle through the deck, just tell me where to stop. Just right here. Okay, so since we have seen the 3 of spades, so we will take this card out. And this turns out to be the 3 of clubs, the force card. So let's watch the tutorial of the slip cut force. You need to keep the 3 of clubs on the top of the deck or the force card. For demonstration purposes, here we keep the 3 of clubs face up on top of the deck. So as I riffle through the deck, I keep a hold on the top card, that is the 3 of clubs. So when the spectator says stop, I slip the top card, that is the force card, to the correct position as such. For misdirection, you may say that since we have seen the 3 of spades, that is this card, so we will go for the card that is underneath it. So forcing the 3 of clubs. One more time, I riffle, they say stop, and then you slip cut the top card, that is the 3 of clubs, on the correct position and saying that we do not want the 5 of diamonds, so we go for the card underneath it, and that is the 3 of clubs. Okay, I am going through cards. In fact, just go and touch one card. Just right here. Okay, so this is your card, the 3 of clubs. So let's see how it's done. Keep the 3 of clubs on top of the deck. Here we keep it face up for demonstration. Count the cards as such, maximum 2 to 3. And then spread the cards by saying okay, just go and touch one card while keeping those 2 to 3 cards below the spread. Let's say they touch this card, cut the spread at this point and then square up the right pile. Let's get a better look from below. Count the cards maximum 2 to 3 and then spread those cards while keeping those 2 to 3 cards below the spread. Let's say they selected this card, cut the spread at this point, squaring up the right pile, flip it over, and thus forcing the 3 of clubs. Let's see it again in fast motion, keeping the 3 of clubs face up on the deck. Count the cards, spread the cards, cut it where they touch, square up, flip it over, and thus forcing the 3 of clubs.
The next force is the no card force. As obviously the name suggests, it does not require any cards. Since it uses magician's choice and equivoque, so I cannot give a whole performance and then a tutorial. So I will be giving a performance plus tutorial. So this, let's say we want to force the king to the spectator. So this is what we need to say to the spectator. Imagine a box which contains both the picture cards and the number cards. The picture cards containing the king, queen, jack, and the number cards from ace to 10. So these are two groups, and you need to take one of the groups out of the box. Now at this point, if they say the picture cards, so the magician or you is going to say that imagine those picture cards which you have taken out of the box on the air. Now ask them to give any two of the picture cards from the king, queen, jack to you, the magician. Let's say if they give the jack and a queen, then you will be saying that, okay, so now I get the jack and the queen, that is you are left with the king, and thus we simply force the king to the spectator. But if they say that they will give to the magician the king and the jack, or the king and the queen, then you may say, okay, so I have the king and the jack, go and select one of these by the process of elimination. And now, if they select the king, you may say, okay, so you get the king as you select it. But if they say the jack, you say, okay, by the process of elimination, we will be eliminating the jack and thus we are left with the king. Thus, in all the ways, we force the king. Now, as we complete the forcing part, it is time for some recommendations. First is Stuff Force by Danny Daoutis. You need to check out his stuff as he has got some great stuff on psychological card forcing. Second, this is Clear Choice by Thinking Paradox. If you are stage magician, you will love this trick as this is the best method for a stage magician to force anything, not just cards. It can be anything. So you need to check this out. One way forcing decks or using Svengali decks are always great. So you need to buy those. All of the required links are actually provided in the description below. So go check those out, and as always, thanks for watching.